Drongo sister was a wise, deeply thoughtful person, skilled with the uses of local herbs.
Otorongo made her tomb hard enough to find.
In honor of her passion for nature, she was entombed within one of Solis's natural wonders.
Open.
Time to learn what the Dorongo sister has to tell us.
Forest mountains breaking. Mean anything to you?
Huh. Curious. Very curious. It still makes so little sense. There must be much more to this. This place. I'm ashamed to tell you, Rico, that in my youth, I was one of the researchers responsible for sanitizing this ruin.
Yeah. You said you had a part in sanitizing this place.
Archaeologists in Solis are trained to reconstruct the truth. We were historical spin doctors, nothing more. This place was my first assignment, fresh from school. A park celebrating the false history. My eyes were opened here.
Be glad they were opened at all.
Every day, my friend. Ironically, Otorongo's fiercest general and ally, rumored to have killed hundreds of Spaniards, despite their superior weaponry and armor, is buried in this mockery of history.
What was his name?
Sadly, lost to Espinosa manipulation of the facts. I hope we can restore it somehow.
Okay, that's fine. Love being out.
Thank you. my back.
¿Dónde está?
Need a massage.
pulse open, Javi.
We struggled to solve this riddle in my youth. When it defeated us, we simply built this heinous park to hide it in plain sight.
In the east, in third among. Another broken line. No help.
No help? Rico. Interred. Evidence that we will find Otorongo's burial ground. But where in the east? We are making some progress, but I don't yet understand the significance. Por favor, Rico. You must help me find more verses. Trail of Otorongo's tomb? Spinoza mythos tells us that Otorongo's oldest child was a violent maniac. Standards for such things were different then. But I'm inclined to believe, if the Espinosas taught it, the opposite must be true. Youngest son of Odorongo was thought to be very sickly and ill, the result of frequent beatings. Beatings were common in those days. But why would a king waste an heir? It is nonsense.
You have a soothing voice, Avihuerta. That's one.
Suggests that Otorongo's offspring were not yet considered adults by the society at large. This may mean that the Espinosas murdered children to prevent the line from continuing.
That's two. Mira, gather everyone. I think we're ready for Ayapa.
Listo. I'll have everyone waiting at Estación Atalaya.
It's time to take the fight to Espinosa. One. Vault's open. Let you know what I find.
Si. Please do.
Waiting the green faces of my forebears.
Ironic. To leave such a message on the tomb of one's own children. Gracias, friend. I will think on this new addition. sailor's account describes how many of Otorongo's subjects hid behind the great doors of this temple. The Espinosa's men rode in through a secret entrance and enslaved those they did not execute. thought to belong to Otorongo's wisest advisor. We call him El Sabio. The Espinosa narrative would have us believe he was a monster sorcerer and occultist.
Let me guess. None of that is true.
His name is lost, but the legends of his wisdom, compassion, and strength survived in some of the relics destroyed by Espinosa's archaeologists.
Sabio's vault is open.
Let's see what secrets he has for us.
Here, waves along the ocean shore.
What a cryptic verse. Like this tomb hidden on the ocean shore. It's maddening. Think, Javi.
I know you'll figure it out.
I feel in my bones and my soul that we are close, but something is yet missing. That is the tomb of Otorongo's spouse, only recently unearthed. It seems great care was taken to bury it. Trail about Orongo's tomb? We know so little about the women of Orongo's time. We can surmise their marriage was arranged. They may not have loved each other, but I think it is clear that they were loyal comrades all the same.
Why is that?
Would you have taken such great care to entomb someone if they were meaningless to you?
Thank you.
My empire there lies dead.
Fascinating. The Empire of Otorongo spent much of Solis, and possibly beyond. Rico, my friend, this is it. I figured it out. Arranged in the correct order, these lines. Far in the east, interred among the forest mountains breaking waves along the ocean shore. My empire there lies dead and buried. Only 5 beds remain, awaiting the grim faces of my forebears. I know now. It is all so clear. Rico, I will meet you in Kuya. Together, we will open Otorongo's tomb.
Rico, the poem. It was brilliant. And I finally figured it out.
So, you found Old Man Otorongo's tomb?
It's right here. Built on the ruins of Otorongo City. His tomb is buried below.
What do we do now?
There are 5 Umas here. Some were taken to museums. Some still stand in their original places. But they are here. And there are 5 locks in the park below. It is Otorongo's tomb. It must be.
Relic to such nonsense.
Music's got a good beat.
Far in the east, interred among the forest mountains breaking waves along the ocean shore. Where else could it be but this beautiful landscape? Which the Alpa people called home.
Thank you.
big statue came out of the ground.
Miraculous. Busy people drive by every day, yet never grasp the significance of what surrounds them. It's a portrait of our time, see or no? My empire there lies dead and buried. Only 5 beds remain, awaiting the grim faces of my forebears. The seat of Otorongo's empire was here, until the Espinosas began to erect their own city on top of it. And this is where he locked away his secrets, using the great Umas as his keys. This atrocity. The Espinosas and their hack archaeologists know no shame.
Another statue.
Yes. Yes. For centuries, we've been told these giant heads were mere curiosities. People took selfies with them. And the poem was written in the language of the Espinosa conquistadors. Otorongo possessed such foresight. He knew that few or none of his descendants would speak the Quechua tongue.
Now I get it.
There we go.
Can you imagine the great Alba city that was once here? It was surely the eighth wonder, before Diego Espinosa tore it apart brick by brick. remarkable. We're making history, Rico.
Why are you out of breath?
Lots of stairs.
No elevator?
Forgot. Too excited.
One more to go. This is the last one.
When the tomb is revealed, we should be ready. We may need to leave in a hurry.
That's all of them.
I'm coming. Listo. Let's go. Hurry. This is amazing, Rico. I am truly giddy. We have Otorongo's sarcophagus. What treasures will we... Inside.
Something tells me you'll be more jazzed about it than me.
But the truth should excite all of us, Rico. Espinoza and his family, all terrible people. Generations of them, exposed for liars, thieves, and murderers. We cannot leave the tomb. I will call one of my men for extraction. Please, Rico, bring us a vehicle that can haul the sarcophagus to safety.
Nice.
my men is coming with a helicopter.
Hostile hasn't re-engaged. Eyes open for further contact.
Woman.
The fiercest leader of one of the most advanced cultures of the ancient world was not a king, but a queen. A star chart. Constellations. Look at the detail. A deed. Transferring ownership of Solis to the Spanish for 2 pounds of silver. What's that?
It's a journal, written in Spanish.
That's, very interesting. The, oils on your skin.
Hey, what about the oils on your skin?
Dios mío. Otorongo's final days. It describes how her entire family was assassinated one by one by the conquistador Diego Espinosa de Malaga. This rewrites all of Solis' history. The indigenous peoples were not a warlike tribe of barbarians, but a highly scientific, progressive, and matriarchal society. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias, Rico. Bueno. Ayúdame. We'll have to get this someplace safe. There's so much work to be done. There's so much left for you to teach me, Su Majestad.
I'm just...